In the last exercise, we used alpha and jitter to reduce overplotting. But it turns out that there's more that we can do. Let's hear from Maura about how she used her domain knowledge and a transformation to make an adjustment to her scatter plot.
The next thing that I did was to take, again, their perceived audience size and their actual audience size, but this time I transformed the axes. So this time it's as a percentage of their friend count. Some people in the study had 50 friends, some had 100, some had 2,000. And so it actually makes more sense to think about your audience size as a percentage of the possible audience. All of the people in this study had shared their post with friends-only privacy, so you'd expect that it would be bounded by their friend count. So what we found when we plotted it this way was that all of the points are below this line of perfect accuracy, this diagonal line, really well below. And one other thing I should note about this plot, we actually ran two different surveys. We ran one survey where we asked people in a single post, how many people do you think saw your post? But we also asked a different set of people, in general, how many people do you think see the content that you share on Facebook? And so that's what this plot is showing. This is the in general question. And their guesses are a little bit higher, but still, people typically think that maybe 10% of their friends see their content, when in reality it's more like 40 or 50%, even 60% of their friends will see their content in a given month. So that's what this plot is showing, is the percentage of friends who actually saw their content in the last month. Again, they're underestimating.